The reality is, go back to the question that was asked over there. How do the players get to a tournament? Somebody has to buy their plane tickets. Somebody has to spend money on a camp for them. Somebody has to arrange friendlies for them. They can't do it on their own. We don't take the credit for them being on the field of play because they achieved that thing. The fact that Matiba had to pass the law to Norton, we can't take credit for that. That's their IP, if you want to call it, for want of a better word. They put that, constructed that together in their head, looking at a gap, picking up the head, etc. We've always said the likes of what put Benny aside from a number of players, both on the African continent and the world, was he had that ability of the 5 to 7 seconds. As the ball was being received, he already knew where he was going to play this ball. Whereas in most other cases, people get the ball and now they lift their head up. We can't take credit for that. But we need to be given credit for the fact that we have placed it in context. Banyana Banyana, we spent over 20 million rand on Banyana Banyana's preparations to get them to the World Cup. It's not money down the drain, it's money well spent. Because we have placed those players on a world stage and creating career opportunities for them. They didn't wake up one morning and walk into a team and say, I'm playing here. No, somebody had to go out and select them. And we can go on and on and on with this process. I mean, we were discussing the last couple of days, you know, Banyana Banyana. We played those teams that were in the semi-finals.
3 out of 4.
And we were not disgraced by any of them when we had played. We had drawn with Sweden. We lost 1-0 to the Netherlands, and I think it was 3-0 to the USA. Other teams have lost by far greater margins to those teams. And yet, we say, we're not looking to steal anybody's credit, but we're saying, we provide the opportunities. That's our responsibility as a federation. Nobody is getting into a national team by themselves. Waking up in the middle of Mitchell's Plain, or waking up in the middle of Soweto or Kakamas, etc., and saying, okay, here I am for a national team. They go through a progression. We mentioned it right at the beginning of this thing, where we said the likes of the McCarthys, the Matthew Booths. Matthew Booth was living in Fishhook. His dad used to drive him down the road there to go and play at the Fishhook thing. And then eventually he came down and played at Hartbevel. Eventually he was in the under-16 team at provincial level. He ended up in the national team at under-17. He was in the provincial team for the under-20s, who won that trophy, then the United Bank trophy, won that 4 times. And then he ventured in the under-23s. And then he ended up in Bafana Bafana. Ended up playing professional football here. Ended up playing professional football abroad. Those were opportunities that were created through the National Association, which provides that. So we're not taking credit from anybody, but we should be giving credit for the opportunities that we create. The same way with Banyana Banyana. Those players, the first time we took them to the USA, how many of them got signed and went to college straight away? We went to the Netherlands, one of the goalkeepers got signed straight away. Those are opportunities that are created, and we're proud of those, because those ladies and or men are advancing their careers, and by default, whichever way you want to do it, you're reducing the unemployment rate in this country as well.